Last class, we started this chapter, how to use MATLAB software for solving optimization problems. So we will continue with that. All these things we discussed in the last class, right? So let us keep it. Okay, now let us solve directly to the problem. So minimize a fx is equal to x square plus 16 by x. So this is a single variable, unconstrained minimization problem. So what are the techniques that you have read it in your this syllabus to solve this type of problem? How many techniques you have read? 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 3, 8. 8 techniques you have read, right? Starting from that exhaustive search method, bounding phase, golden section, Fibonacci, interval hopping, then Newton-Raphson, secant, and the bisection, right? Through MATLAB, if you have a MATLAB software, you can use MATLAB and also solve the same problem, right? For which you have to specify the initial search space that you have to assume. And to do this, you have to use the subroutine, MATLAB subroutine called fminbnd, minimum of f using given the boundary, initial boundary, that is 0 to 5. Okay, how to do it? So this is a single variable unconstrained minimization problem where the search initial search space is given. So the search space is what? The lower bound is 0 and upper bound is 5, right? This is given. And the MATLAB function that you have to use it is fminbnd. So how to use it? So either you can write down this command in the command prompt, but don't worry about this one. There is always what? The menu is there, from there also you can select it and you can able to solve it, right? From command prompt also if you write this thing, you will get the result, or from the menu. So this is the output they will get, okay. Now, when you that screen will come, no, first you select what? Apps and then optimizations, then you get a optimizations screen, you will get it. In that, there are various fields are there. Like this, your screen will get it. When you press apps and then optimizations, such type of screen will appear on your screen. And this screen is called optimization tool. Okay. So the first field is solver. In the solver, you have to select. Here you need to write down all these things. When you keep your mouse in this arrow down, there is arrow down symbol here. When you click it here, then there will be drop down menu. And there all the MATLAB optimizations functions name will be written, and what for it is to be used, that also in detail will also will be written. So one search is your that function name is fminbnd, the one that we discussed, right? And what for it is used, that is explanation also has been given here. So this fminbnd, and this is used for single variable non-linear minimization with bounds. So this you have to select it. Okay, select that. Now the next come is your problem. In problem, they are given problem that you are going to solve it. So in that one thing is that you have to define what is your objective functions, right? So there you simply write down at the rate the file name. Here file name I have given F, you can give any file name XYZ or ABC, the file name whose extension is .m. Now we will see what is to be written in this file, what is to be written, what should be the contents of this file, we will discuss it. Clear? Any doubt? Simply write down at the rate a file name, here file name I have given F. So we will discuss what should be written in the file called f.m. Then below this it is written x1, because it is single variable, so only one variable is there x1, and here you have to know what is it, x1 and x2, yeah, here x1 and x2 is actually, x1 is the lower limit or the lower bound of the variable x, so there you enter 0, because in this problem it is written 0, and x2 is the upper bound of the variable x, so in this field write down the value 5. Next, run solver and view results, press start. this much you have to enter it in the screen and then you will get the result. Any difficulty? Select the function, then write down the file name in which you are defining your objective functions, then specify lower limit, lower bound and the upper bound, then press start. That's it. Then it will it will run for some time and then it gives you result. What is the result it is giving? So it says current iteration 8 means after 8 iterations it has given you the result. Then here what is the value of objective function? Here it is written. Can someone tell me what is the value of objective function? 1.4333178 to the power? Yes, minus 8. So up to what decimal place it has given you the accuracy? What is the accuracy? Not 8, it will be what? Since it started with 1.4, so it will be 7. So 7 decimal point accuracy it has given you the result, right? And at what value of x? Chala gaya, I don't know. Hey, you go to CK Vishwas sir and give your feedback. After the class is over, you meet Professor CK Vishwas and give your feedback. Okay. Now this is the value of and minimum value of f will be almost 0. And what is that x value at which it has occurred? Here below this there is another window where it is final point. Here the value 2 is written. So x is equal to 2, your function will be minimum and that minimum value is 0. This is the way you have to use it. Now question arises, what should you write down in f dot m file? Yes, can anyone tell me? Yes, you have to write down the objective functions in MATLAB format. So let us see. Yes. Y is equal to x square is equal to 16. Minimize. What was the value? I think then this has been solved for some other error. 1 minute. X 1 2 function. Oh, function value should be 12 though.
Yes, sir.
To idhar aise kyun likha? Ruko. Eh, bada kar. Nahi. 0.2. Then this is not the hello. This is not for this function then. Then some other thing I have run it. Yeah, you. Yeah, you are correct. The screen that has been shown is not for the, at the time when I run the program, that time in the f function file, I think it was not x square plus 16 by x. It was I think x minus 2 whole square should be there. You run it again. So this is a mistake. That screen is a mistake. Yeah. So you see here in the f dot m file, you have to write down these two lines. This is a function file. So first line should be started with the word function. Y is equal to f of x. Why f here? Because your function file name is f dot m. If you write down here x y z dot m, here also it should be x, y, z within bracket x should be there. Okay. So here f and this f must match, otherwise it will not work. Then the second layer write down your objective functions. That is x dot star x, this is for x square plus 16 by x. So 16 dot divided by x. This is equal to the value that will be calculated will be stored in the variable y and this y will be written out of these functions. So these two lines must be written in f dot m. Then when you write down at the rate f, then only it will understand. Probably at that time in the f.m file, I have written x minus 2 whole square and run this one. X? You run it and see it. Because it is not using which one? The which one? Exact derivatives. It is using golden section method, right? So it will not give you exactly 0. You try. Numerical methods will never give you 100% accurate results. If you want 100% accurate result, you must use the calculus method. There is first derivative equal to 0, second like this. Okay, so this is the way you can solve single variable unconstrained optimization problem. Next, let us go. Now let us solve example number 2. Minimize the Himmelblau function f of x is equal to x1 square plus x2 minus 11 square plus x1 plus x2 square minus 7 whole square starting from 0 0 using MATLAB inbuilt function fminsearch. How to do it? Same procedure, right? So in the screen you just feed in the data, press start, it will give you the result. Let us see what are the data you have to feed it. So fminsearch is a direct search method without using the derivatives. So you have to define your objective function f in a file and then starting point is 0 0. Let us see how to use it. Have you written down question? Okay, next. So here in so this is a multivariable unconstrained minimization problem and the initial point is 0 0, x1 0, x2 0. So the vector is x0, initial value that is 0 0. Okay. So either you can write down your own file like this, but why to take bothersome this one? Straight away you can use this, which one? The menu, which is more convenient. Okay. Yeah. So as usual, here in the solver you select fminsearch. The explanation given is unconstrained nonlinear minimization, and this is invariably for a multivariable problem. Okay. Next, for the objective function, write down @ the file name. Now, in this file name, I have given fg2. Let us see what should be written in that file name. If you do a mistake while writing the contents of that fg2.m, then you will get the wrong result. So the real trick actually, how to use this for a real trick is that what is that you should write down in that file. We will see that. Start point, define 0 semicolon 0. Here usually we commit mistakes, we forget to write down the semicolon here. So this is, please, this is a point to be noted. You must be 0 semicolon 0, because this is a column vector. If you have seen it in the previous slide, this is a column vector. The starting point is a column vector. So 0 semicolon 0 you have to write down. Yeah. And then square bracket begin, square bracket close. That also you sooner forget to mention, otherwise it will not be a matrix. Square bracket open, 0, then semicolon, then 0, then square bracket close. Not any other bracket, only square bracket it takes. Then press start, it runs, and after 81 iteration it is given you the result, and the value of objective function is how much? 2 to the power minus 10, 8, 1.4333, 10 to the minus 8, so almost 0. And in fact for the Himmelblau function minimum value will be 0. Have you tried or no? It occurs at x is equal to x1 is equal to 3, x2 equal to 2, and the minimum value should be 0. So this function value is almost 0. Let us see what is the x1 and x2 value. So here it is written, 1 means it is x1, 2 means it is x2. Corresponding value is 3, x1 is 3 and x2 is 2. So this is the way you get your result. Now let us see what is to be written in fg2 file. Let us go see. Yeah. In fg2 file, fg2.m, write down function square bracket open f comma gf square bracket close. It means in this functions you are returning two values, means there are two outputs. Input is only one, there is a value of x, but output from the function will be two, one is f, another is gf. Who can guess what is f and what is gf? Anybody who can guess what is that it is returning? If you remember multivariable analytical method, what is that you are calculating? Analytical method, first derivative, then second derivative. What do you call first derivative? Gradient vector. So here actually gf is a gradient of function f. So unless you know how to write down this one, you cannot get the, you will not be able to use that software properly. You know what should be written in this file. This is very, very important. It is not that simply you write down f, then it will be a mistake for you. Is that clear? So in multivariable minimization problem, you must write down the expression for both objective function value as well as the gradient function value. Okay. Now let us see. First line is p1 is equal to x1 square plus x2 minus 11. What does it mean? Yes. What is the value of p1 is x is a vector within bracket 1 means what is the first element, that is x1. X is a vector of which the first element, this symbol dot cap 2 means it is square, then plus second element of x2. Here it should be right down here, which bracket you call it, this one? Which parent? That is, if there is square bracket, this is which bracket? Open bracket. First bracket. What is the name of this bracket? Simple bracket or what? Common bracket, yeah. Then minus 11, right. Then P2 is the other one, x1 plus x2 square minus 7. In the next line, what are you doing? You are doing P1 square. And then you are taking P2 square, you are adding it up, and this is your function value, f. You could have written down here itself also, here also dot square, this one also you could have written, but since p1 is used further, so I have separated it out. Inside the square, whatever is there, I have defined it as p1. The second term inside the bracket, what is there, I have defined as p2. So this is p1 square plus p2 square is equal to f. Here, you mean to say that from here to here it is p1, then square f again, plus inside this bracket I have taken from here to here is p2, square of this is p2. So finally what is that I am doing? p1 square plus p2 square is equal to your f. Over? Okay. So you get your function value, that is your returning. Next what it says, gfx means what? It is actually delta f by delta x1. Whenever you find out your gradient of a multivariable functions, you are finding out partial derivative of f with respect to x1, and another is partial derivative of f with respect to x2. So actually gf1 is actually delta f with respect to x1, del f del x1, and this is your del f del x2, and these two values constitute your gradient vector, because gradient vector is also two elements. So this is your first element, this is your second element. So what was your del f del x1 for this one? You have already solved it earlier. Write down del f del x1 here. Write it down. So how much it will be? 2, whatever is there. So if inside each p, so it will be twice p1, then plus whatever is inside is there. So it will be twice x1. This is 0, this is 0. Right. So it will be twice of whatever is inside, twice of p, then into twice of x1. So this is the what, and the second one will be what? The twice of p2 plus x1, if you take derivative of x1, it will be 1 only. So, it will be only twice of p2. So, the same thing can be written here. So, then of course, if when you simplify it, we are getting So, this is twice of p2, this is correct second term into 1, and this is y4, yes, because twice first and then x1 square, this twice x1, 2 into 2, 4. So, that is why 4 into x1 into p1. Any doubt? No. You have to write it down here. Yes, any other doubt?
Sir,
yeah.
Actually, when we give the specify the input argument, why shouldn't we specify x1 and x2? We are giving two values.
Which value? X1?
F of fg2 of symbol x we give as function.
Which is x?
fg2 of x.
fg2?
Of x.
Yes.
But we have to give both for x1 and x2, right?
See here, in MATLAB, the variable x is a matrix, it is an array. It understands it, right. In x is a always, unless another array is specified, the x is always an array. If only one element, it is variable, but it can have, if it is more than one variable, it will be array form. So, if you write down x within bracket 1 means the first element x 1. Whenever you pass x, you have to specify here pass two values, one for x 1, another x 2. Similarly, here this f is only one value and gf is a what? Because you are writing gf1, gf2, automatically decides that it is an array of two elements. So, this is only scalar quantity, one value, but gf will be two values. One is gf1, there is del f del x1, and we know that gradient vector is a vector having two elements, and this is del f del x2. And then write down return. Return is optional statement, you may give it, you may not give it. Yes, any doubt? Time ho gaya kya? Ghadi dekhta hai? Another 15 plus 10, 25 minutes. Now, time is how much?
5?
Yeah, 56, correct. Okay. So, next. So, this is clear? Next, let us get it. Now, third example, solve it. Same thing, only thing instead of fmin search, you have to use fminunc. This is a gradient based method. So, here you select fminunc in the solver, that is unconstrained nonlinear minimization algorithm large scale. Objective function same. Whatever you have written for fmin, the same file can work here, at the rate fg2. And here you have two gradients have been supplied, starting point 0,0, press start. Then it will give you the result. So, the result is to the power 10 to the power minus 17. So, 16 decimal place accuracy it is giving. And the value is x1 is 3, x2 is 2. Yeah. Function value?
For the previous one.
Do we need
gradient function in
now? You try, don't give this one and try only f and see whether you are getting all. Okay. His doubt is that why we require to give the gradient of fg2. You try, let us see. Yeah, previous one, I am telling you. You try and then if you succeed, then we will see. Next. Okay. Now, let us see the fourth example. Use MATLAB function using an fmincon to solve this constrained minimization problem. One objective function and there are two constraints and this is that boundary for x1 and x2. Write down the problem. So, your doubt is genuine, why is that gradient we are required to supply, nahi? Let me find it out. Over. Now, let us see how to supply, how to specify. So, first format is that you have to express everything in the standard MATLAB format, and MATLAB format is it must be always expressed in minimize. So, this is already minimized, so no problem. So, minimize fx subject to all inequality constraints should be less than or equal to 0, but here it was greater than or equal to. So, you have to convert it to less than or equal to. So, what is to be done? Multiply minus 1 both the sides for both the constraints. Had it been any equality constraint, then it should be hx is equal to 0. Here of course, there is no equality, and for each independent variable you have to specify lower bound and upper bound. So, here only what? Only one boundary is there. What is the other boundary? Yes. For x 1 only one boundary is given. What is the other boundary? Infinity. Very good. Plus infinity. X 2 also lower boundary is 0, upper boundary is plus infinity. Okay. So, first thing is that objective functions you have written down in min, you have just copied it down because it is already given in minimization format. We have two inequality constraint, G type of constraint, two, the first one and the second one. Now, multiply minus 1 both the sides. So, it will be converted to less than or equal to. So, whatever is there in the left hand side, it will be G1x, and for the second one, it will be G2x. And on the right hand side, it should be nothing other than 0. If any number is there, you have to take it to the left hand side. It is already 0 is there, so you don't have to bother. Here there is no equality constraints, and variable bound is x1, x2 less than or equal to plus infinity greater than or equal to 0. In this format, you have to express it first. Over. With this data, let us see how to fill in the in that screen, how to enter the various data. Okay, next. So, G 1 is equal to which one? G 1, the first constraint, then find out its gradient, find it out. So, gradient will be what? Del g 1 del x 1 del g 1 del x 2. So, find it out, take derivative. So, for 26 with respect to x 1 will be 0, x 1 minus 5 whole square. So, it will be twice of x 1 minus 5, and inside it is if you x 1 minus 5 if you take derivative to x 1, it will be for x 1 it will be 1, and for 5 it will be 0. So, into 1 plus x 2 with respect to x 1 it will be 0.
So, next step is plus 2 x
2. Which one?
Sir, next del g 1 del x 2 must be plus 2 x
2. Here.
X 2 square.
Here.
Second line.
Here.
Plus 2 x 2. Sir, last 2 x 2 that must be plus.
Here.
Sir, first case.
Where? Yes. So, please correct it. See, 26 it will be 0, and with respect to x 2 this will be 0, and here it will be plus 2 x 2. Yes. Please correct it. This is not minus, it is plus 2 x 2. So, here also it will be plus 2 x 2. Please correct it. Over. Similarly, repeat it for the g 2. Find out its gradient del g 2 So it will be constant, 4 and 1. Why it is a constant? Because it is a linear function. It is not non-linear. Over. Next. So this let us forget. This so in solver, select fmincon. This is constraint non-linear minimization. In algorithm, select active set. In objective function, write down the file name at the rate, the file name is fg2c. We will see what is to be written in fg2c. Here we are supplying the gradient. So gradient supplied, start point is 00. Do not forget to put semicolon between the two zeros and to write down open bracket and close bracket, then this should be square bracket. Now in earlier functions, there were no need of constraints, but here there is a separate block called constraints. So since this constraints we are specifying in the file name called gh2c, so here we are not specifying, right? The left hand side of inequality constraint, what is that? Oh, linear inequality. There is no linear inequality here. Are there any linear inequalities? No. So there was nothing A, nothing on the right hand side B. Similarly, equality linear, nothing was there, and this one nothing is there. So everything was in non-linear constraint functions. Yes? Even if it is there, so I have kept it in here itself, in the non-linear. Both the two constraints I have written down in this in the file name. You can keep it in here also, right? And then lower bound is 0, upper bound is, if you do not specify it, it will be treated as infinity. So start, after 15 iterations, it will give you the result minus 10 to the power 7, almost 0. So like this, in the final point, it will be written x1 is equal to 3, x2 is equal to 2. Now let us see what is to be written in fg2 for the objective function with gradient. So f, then gf. Similarly, p1, p2 and f is equal to p1 square, p2 square, same as whatever you have written down. Now in the gradient portion, you have to write down this f, this n arg out greater than or equal to 1, and for this if this is the end, and in this you have to write down these two gradient functions. So this is for gf1 and this is for gf2, for the g functions, which one? The first gradient. So this file is almost same or no, the one that you have discussed in the FG1C, FG1, any difference? This is del F1, del X1, and this is del F1, del X2, this line. And this is del F1, del X1, this is del F1, del X2. For the objective functions, with respect to X1 is this one, with respect to X2 is this one. But this is the line you have to write down, otherwise it will make mistakes, right? If n arg out greater than 1 like this, then end. Over. Which one? This one? This you have to write it down, other you will not understand. Number of argument out is greater than 1. So here how many arguments are there? Here in this output, how many arguments are there? 2, na? So greater than 1. So you have to write down like this. Okay. Now next go to, this is for G function, the constraint functions.
In the previous case, we directly need to write the else condition.
Which one? Else. Which previous? The previous one. There it is not required. No, this is not required. And try first time with this one, and if you do not write this one, try with the other one. And let me know what is the result. And here also you try, do not write this one and try to see if you are getting the same result or not. Do some experiments and try to learn, right? This programming, first you try with without these two line and try. If you do not get it, try this line. Okay. Okay, next. So why there are four arguments here? Yes. One is for G for G inequality type of constraints, and H is for equality type. Here H is not there, but still you have to write this four this ones. You have to provide four arguments here. One for G, another for H, and this GG is what? Gradient of G, and GH is gradient of H. So here, since there is no H function, you will write down H is equal to a null matrix. That is why GH will be null. Otherwise, like this you have to define it for H1 and H2. Just like G1, G2 you have written down, here also H1, H2. As many number of H is there, H1, H2, H3 is there. If only one H is there, write only H1. So, this is for the first constraint G1 value, and this is for the second constraint G2. So, accordingly for G there will be gradient vector, again two element. Similarly, for 2, the second G plus 1, another 2. So, could you now able to appreciate why 1 1 1 2 2 1 2 2 is there? In earlier one, only 1 1 2 1 is there. What does it mean? Because there are only one F functions, so that is why only 1 1 here. But in the second case, there are 2 G functions are there. So, this is for the del F del X, this one is for del F del X1 with respect to X1, these two is for with respect to X2. And this one is, because only one F function is there, so that is why it is 1. But in the second case, there are 2 G what are there, G1 and G2. So, that is why here you have to write down 1 and another is 2 here. So, this 1 1 means for the first G1, and this 2 2 means this is for the G2, and this 1 means del F is with respect to X1, this 2 is with respect to X2. Is that clear? The first line is refers to G1, and this one G1 with respect to del X1, and this is G1 with respect to del X2, because for every gradient you have to find two elements, one respect to x1 and another respect to x2. See, now the second line, see here constant 4 and 1. So, this was g2 functions. For g2 functions, this is a with respect to x1, this is with respect to x2. Any doubt? So, simply filling it there has got no value. Unless and otherwise you know how to write down these functions, this file name, you are not going to get the correct result. So, the real brain lies here, how to write down these two files, these files, the functions files, which we are going to reproduce there.